What's up, guys? Keegan here with Jordan Distributors. Today, we are going to be showing you step-by-step how to install our plug-and-play push-to-start conversion kit. I will have a list down below in the video description of the vehicles that this install guide applies to, as well as other information that you will need to reference during install. Without any further ado, let's get started. For this install, we are going to start by disconnecting the battery. Next, we will move inside the car and remove the lower dash panel in the driver's knee area, as well as the clamshell surrounding the steering column. With these out of the way, we could begin the removal of the factory ignition switch. We just need to locate the single brown connector on the bottom of the key cylinder, unplug it, and plug in our plug-and-play push-to-start harness. It is worth noting that you may need to remove some of the loom tape from this harness on the vehicle side so that you can better secure the connectors under the dash instead of here at the steering column. If you would like to mount your start button in the factory keyhole for a nice OEM look, then you will need to remove the factory key cylinder. The key cylinder is held in place with two screws located on the top. To gain access to these screws, you will need to unplug the connectors from the turn signal and wiper controls, as well as the airbag. These are tamper-proof screws that have no screw head to be able to turn them, so you will need to use a chisel and hammer. Just give them a few light taps to get them to turn. Don't worry, they aren't held in place that tight, and removing them is actually much easier than you may expect. If you would rather leave the factory key cylinder in place and mount your start button somewhere else, you can skip this step. Next, we need to attach the black wire to ground. There are a few different places that you can attach your ground wire. We have found it easiest to place the ring terminal under one of these nuts found here at the brake pedal assembly. Next, we need to attach the quick connector from our kit to the brake switch. We will have a chart in the description below that shows which color wire you will need to attach to for your specific vehicle. Simply line up the connector and give it a gentle squeeze with a pair of pliers until it is clicked into place. Then you can simply plug the orange wire from our kit into this connector. Now to install the antenna. The antenna wiring is quite long, which will allow you to mount the antenna nearly anywhere that you would like. We chose to put it here behind this lower trim panel for easy access. However, if you would like to place the antenna somewhere else that is harder to find for added security, you most certainly can do so. Last but not least, we need to install the start button itself. This wire is also quite long, so if you would like to mount it on the dash or somewhere other than the factory keyhole, you will have plenty of wire to be able to do so. This button is the same size as the factory keyhole and requires no cutting or modification to get it to fit. One thing to note is the fact that these cars come equipped with an immobilizer. If you would like to install your start button in the factory keyhole like we did in our shop vehicle, then you will need to address the immobilizer. Once you have removed the key cylinder, you will need to remove the key transponder from the end of the key cylinder by removing the Phillips head screws. You can then secure one of your factory keys to the key transponder and keep it plugged into the vehicle and secure it under the dash. Our kit will then act as the immobilizer for the vehicle. However, if you would like to keep the factory immobilizer functional, as well as the steering column lock, then you can install your start button elsewhere and skip this step. It is worth noting that if you remove the factory key cylinder to mount your start button in the factory keyhole, then you will lose the function of the steering wheel lock. It does look nice to mount the start button in the factory keyhole, but if you would like to mount it somewhere else so that you can keep the steering wheel lock, you most certainly can do so. For an example, we are going to show mounting the start button to this dash panel. Simply mark the hole, and then with a hole saw, drill the hole for your button. We have these properly sized hole saws available on our website if you would like to purchase one. Any household drill will work just fine. If you choose to do your install this way, then the process for starting the vehicle will be as follows. Simply insert the key into the ignition and turn it one click to unlock the steering column. Then, put your foot on the brake and press the button once to start. If you choose to install your button this way, make sure that you do not, under any circumstances, remove the key from the ignition while driving. The steering column will relock. Now, the only thing that you have left is to plug everything in to the push-to-start module, secure this box as well as all of the wires neatly under the dash, and reinstall the clamshell and lower dash panels. The install is now complete. Go ahead and reconnect the battery. Scan your key tag over the antenna, put your foot on the brake, push the button, and the car will start right up. If you want to see the future, then take a look at us.